Yeah. Next speaker, Dr. Vasudevan from VIT.
Good evening to all. So in this presentation, I would like to discuss about the two part. The first part consists of like a 4D printing, the smart materials for the future. This is just I would like to share what VIT has been, what is involved in transferring the latest technology to the common man, what is initiative VIT has taken. Second one, CSRD, Center for Sustainable Rural Development Center available at VIT, and what are the various activities that have been done nearby villages and other places in VIT. 4D printing is nothing but an opportunity which the objects that change and adapt in response to the surrounding environment. I think today morning Professor from IIT Bombay has mentioned about the 3D printing and rapid prototyping machining and other processes. So it's like an extension of the 3D printing with other next dimension is nothing but the time. The term 4D printing essentially refers to the 3D printed objects that have an added dimension that is called the time. These 3D objects that will transform and change shape over time upon exposure to some external stimuli. Those can be like such as a heat like a thermoresistive or solvent like a chemical responsive or light photoresistive responsive and so on. So depending upon the external stimuli or whatever we apply, it will assemble themselves to form like a structure or form like a machine. That is the latest technology that was developed by MIT just a few years back. So now VIT has been involved in transferring the technology to common man very quickly. So these are the various applications that for 4D printing can be accommodated. And among these various applications, we have planned to focus mainly on the health issues. So these are the recent developments in 4D printing. The first one shows the self-assembly of line installation at Long Beach, CA. Next one, it was done like a 3D printed mechanism and have been done by at room temperature. What is happening? It is getting assembled together because of the external like a room temperature. That is a complex jointed parts. Third one is nothing but a piece of ABS filament, which is at the room temperature. When it is exposed to higher temperature, it will change its shape. So these are the basic idea that motivate us to think about how it can be utilized for health purposes. That motivate us to bring in like 4D bioprinting. 4D bioprinting is nothing but this is a collaborative effort with UFRT France and CMC Hospital, Medical College Hospital, and VIT Vellore. And we are planning to bring the 4D printing, like a bioprinting, like a tissues, organs, how it can be 3D printed, how it can be responsive for the environment, like a room temperature or the body health, like blood and so on. So there are various approaches. The first approach is a substrate material like a smart biopolymer or responsive hydrogel upon stimulus folds into a predefined 3D configuration, and the printed cell or tissue material simply follow the folding of the substrate and form into a desired shape. This is the first approach that we have planned to follow. Second one is in vivo 4D bioprinting, in which a 3D printed polymer medical device is going to be implanted first, then accommodates the growth of the tissue or organ over the particular period. So it is going to be developed in 3D printing, then it is going to be incorporated in our body, then it will accommodate the environment. This is the two plans that we have planned. So in this one, VIT University is going to fund like a 50% of the total cost. Like the total budget comes around 8 crores to 9 crores, and VIT University is going to take care of the 50%. The remaining 50% we have contacted Indian Council of Medical Research and Department of Biotechnology, and in cooperation with UFRT and Christian Medical College, we have initiated the project. And during the last visit to France last year, just we have tried to replicate by using like a morphology of the piece of tough hydrogen upon wetting at room temperature from water, then when it is exposed to dry condition at room temperature, how the shape is going to be changed. And we have made successful, and we have taken the initiative for identifying the tissues and organs now we are discussing with. So it is an initial stage, like a past 1 year we have done, and we have replicated what is already done actually. So this is the one that we have done in VIT on regarding the mega project. Next one, is a various activities that have been done, Center for Sustainable Rural Development and Research and Study, like CSRD and RS. The main aim of the CSRD and RS is to improve the quality of the life of the rural folks by meeting the basic needs of the present without compromising the ability of the future generation to participate planning and implementation. This is a main aim of the CSRD and RS center. And before going to these various activities, just would like to express the quote what was mentioned by Lao Tzu: go to the people, live among them, learn from them, serve them, plan with them, start with what they know, build on what they have, and when the best leaders leave, the people will say, we have done it ourselves. This is a main, this is a motivation for creation of the Center for Sustainable Rural Development Center at VIT. So the mission is to promote sustainable rural development through participative planning, capacity building, effective networking, research and innovative efforts. Actually, the center was inaugurated by His Excellency Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam on 1st December 2005. So actually we are working mainly nearer to the two districts. One is Thiruvannamalai and Vellore district. There are so many small villages, and we mainly focus on those villages, how to educate the people and how we can train them in various technical activities, what are the facilities available at VIT. These are the main partners. We are also collaborating with various government agencies like Tamil Nadu government, other SME and other micro and macro entrepreneurs also. These are the various projects and programs that we are doing at VIT. Pura, it was initiated by former President Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam for provision of urban amenities in rural areas. Just what we do in this program, we directly go to the people and talk to them and discuss with them what they need and identify their needs accordingly. We help them to come out their life. Second one for women empowerment. So in this, we call the scheme like a OES Park, public-private. This is just like a public-private partnership model. And actually, we have a self-help group in Tamil Nadu. We help the people for the rural areas, and then whatever the product they do, so we help them to marketing those products, and so that they will their life can be improved. That is the second program. Third one, we have the social student responsibility, and these are the various activities that we do: school tree plantation program, promoting social and entrepreneurship, gathering and helping in marketing rural products, organizing workshops and events on social themes. So we go to the various villages and organize workshop kind of things, and we teach them how to operate a computer, how to develop, for example, how to maintain the accounts. Everything we teach them, whatever they need for running a small-scale businesses. And we also go, we train the people from various technical training, whatever the facility available as a technical institution. For example, in youth skill training, these are the various areas we train the people like turning, fitting, welding, painting, carpenter, CNC programming, rural BPO, AC and fridge maintenance, garments, fashion designing, screen printing, motor rewinding, digital photography and videography, mushroom cultivation and beautician. These are some of the activities that we do nearby villages. This chart shows what are the various people trained so far in various activities for the past few years. Next one is for forestation and river restoration, and we mainly taken the green Vellore as the main motto, because the Vellore, we have the Pala River, it was totally wasted, there is no even water, and we have now taken care of the Pala River, and we are cleaning and developing, and we are trying to get some water from the river. So it was initiated by VAT. Next one, we have another program called NEEDS. Then we have Village Resource Center, VRC, and Village Knowledge Center. Then we have tribal development, in which major economy activities are done, like honey processing, small village processing, trading, forest producers trading like amla, then kaduki, the tamarind. Whatever the product, whatever they cultivate in their local villages, we try to market, and then we bring the those product to VIT, and then we publish and do a marketing kind of thing at VIT. So these are some of the photographs that we done for the past few years. AC and fridge maintenance was done by our faculty members. We'll train the train the people. And next one is a photography training, food processing and job mela. Then SSC products, and we do the marketing and discuss with the people. And we have another one is called University Higher Education Trust, in which we recruit, take the students from all over, like villages, and without any fees, and then we without any accommodation and tuition fee, we train the people and we provide admission. So far we have done for around 500 people for admission for BTech and various programming. These are the highlights programming that we have done at VIT, like Agriculture Export, VIT campus, financial literacy program, job mela, and through GV school development scheme, we have 40 students benefited. And we have also participated in Swachh Bharat Abhiyan and identified 2,900 beneficiaries and Vellore Small City. Thank you.